Good morning, everybody. We are from the team Ek Shiksha Chemistry, and we would like to introduce you to our project, a database to animation framework. We who did this project are a team of five. I am Abhinaya, that is Aishwarya, this is Shreya, this is Ankur, and this is Srikant. Srikant worked on the 3JS animations. Shreya worked on the design of the database for organic chemistry. Aishwarya and I worked on the database design for inorganic chemistry, and Ankur helped us with the UI. Now I'd like to walk you through the outline of this presentation. First, I'll talk about the objective of our project, then continue with the process of how we did it. Then Aishwarya will continue with the demo, and Shreya will continue with the challenges, learning, and conclude. The main aim of this project was to explore the usage of 3D animations to teach and learn chemistry. According to a research paper published in 2013, students face difficulty in understanding certain concepts in chemistry because they find it hard to visualize certain three-dimensional aspects of certain concepts. Teachers find it hard to represent these by the traditional methods of teaching, that is a chalk and a board. So they usually have additional aids such as audio and video clips. But we wanted to do this using 3D animations, and we wanted to use 3JS for this purpose, as this gives the user complete control over the object in question. Now about the process. Chemistry is a subject where there's a lot of data involved, and to illustrate different concepts, different animations need to be used. Even if the same object is studied, for example, a molecule, what we represent to understand the concept varies from different concepts. For example, take a molecule. What we understand on a molecule for a chemical reaction or hybridization would vary. So we designed a database to animation framework where each table in the database represents a concept, and the different rows will ultimately be converted to an animation. Now Aishwarya will continue with the flow.
This diagram here represents the entire process in which our database to animations framework was created. Since chemistry is a data intensive subject, we had a lot of data which needed to be stored. So our entire chemical data is stored in the database, and this is supplemented by 3JS objects that take this data as parameters, and these parameters are used to create the animations. The animations are created in the animator, which together with the user interface that we created form the chemistry learning tool. Now we'll go to a demo of our project. This is our home page. These are the various topics that we have selected. To select the various topics, we did a bit of a research. We had to find the topics where we felt that the students faced difficulty, mainly because they were involved with certain concepts that could only be understood with three-dimensional visualization. So based on that, we selected a few topics, and these topics further have subtopics under them. On clicking on any of the subtopics, you can see the various options. Here I'll show you atomic structure. You can see the periodic table. This is a dynamic periodic table where the students can learn by interacting with it. Hovering over the different elements will show the different properties of the elements, and clicking on any of the elements will show its structure. Now we have different views for the atom. This here is the full view, which represents the entire nucleus and the electronic configuration. We can also select different views, like the electron view, which focuses mainly on the electronic configuration, or the valence view, where the student can see the valence electrons. These different views, we believe, can be used to teach different concepts. The student can also input any atomic number and view the properties of the element directly. For ease of understanding, like in case anyone's not able to understand how to move through the animations, we also have tips provided. And every topic is associated with a description, which also has audio features that can be read out. These tips and descriptions for the different topics are also stored in our database. We have also implemented chemical reactions. For teaching purposes, we decided to focus on four major types of reactions, as you can see. Selecting one reaction, we can see the menu. This is a generic combination reaction which shows a mechanism where two reactants come together to form the product. The students can input the reactants, the reaction is seen. This is H plus plus Cl minus forming HCl. I'll give you an example of another reaction. This is a decomposition reaction. As you can see, this is a mechanism. This is 2H2O forming 2H2 plus O2. Now Shreya will be talking about the organic chemistry aspects.
In the organic chemistry, we have covered the topics of hybridization of orbitals and some organic reactions. In the hybridization, when we select the subtopic hydrocarbons, we get a list of a number of compounds. Selecting any one compound will let us view the molecular structure of that particular compound. For example, this is a molecular structure of propyne. We can easily see the single, double, and the triple bonds. Next, we have the functionality of the type of hydrocarbons, alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes. Selecting any one will help us view the hybridization of orbitals in that particular hydrocarbon, along with the properties of that selected hydrocarbon shown in the sidebar. Next, we have the organic reactions. For example, we have covered SN1 and SN2 reaction. Suppose we click SN2 reaction, we get a list of reactants. Selecting any one reactant will let us view the mechanism of that particular reaction, along with the list showing which atom, which sphere represents which molecule. And this is all we have covered for the organic chemistry. Throughout the journey of developing our project, we have faced a number of challenges. Some of them helped us learn new experiences. We have faced a difficulty of working with many new technologies, most of which we have never dealt before. We also had to be responsible of providing a clear and manageable code that is easy to read as well as to understand. We also had to gain knowledge about version control, without which sharing and merging our code would have been a nightmare. Database management was another challenge for us, as it is the foundation on which our entire project rested. There was a lot to be learned along the way. We learned about various technologies like 3JS library used for creating animations, various Java technologies, and MySQL database. We were fortunate enough to gain various skills like documenting our project, to learn how to work in a team and collaborate with our knowledge and skills. So to conclude, we have developed a web application that renders 3D animations that is used to enhance our learning experience. This web application can be accessed by students to provide enhanced learning experience in various topics of chemistry, spanning class 9th to 12th, and it can be used as a learning tool to visualize the 3D animations in a number of topics in chemistry. Now Ishwara will talk about the future scope of our project.
In order to gain an insight about the work that can be done in the future, we conducted a survey for students in high school and college, where they told us about the topics where they themselves would like to be taught through the use of animations. With the topics that we got, we noted that many of them were already covered by us. There were a few topics where we believe that some work can be done in the future. They include surface chemistry and polymer science, extended concepts in organic chemistry, more reaction mechanisms, optical chemistry, biochemistry, etc. So we believe that by extending our project, we can make this a tool for schools and colleges. Thank you.
All of you had done a course in databases before coming here? No. So you learned SQL and everything, ab initio, is it? But I thought databases are taught in the third year before you come here?
Most of us are second year.
Oh, second year student. So you completed database course in advance. You better score well when you go back and whenever that course is done. How did you find learning MySQL and using it?
It was easy once you get the hang of it.
Okay. But did you read any book or any other documentation on SQL while attempting to learn that, or you just directly on the job?
We've done MySQL in schools, 11th and 12th, basics.
Oh,
at
school?
Least.
It was MySQL in school, my God.
Most of our work was based on what we've done in school only.
I think so. Slowly they will start teaching databases in the first standard, maybe. I don't know. Anyway. Yes, that's very interesting. So, how many lines of code totally? And all working?
Yes, sir.
Hopefully. And well documented. I think excellent work. I will tell you, the professional productivity in companies is also not of this order. Of course, the professional productivity is measured over long periods of years. When you work for 2 months, you have no option but to slog it out. But if I were to tell you, you have to do this continuously for 2 years, you will rebel and run away. So professional, and as you go out in the industry later, there will be periods in your professional activities where you will have to deliver in a very short time against a deadline. And I hope this experience here will help you there.
Yes,
fine. How much was the learning that you had? I'm not talking about quantitative learning, but qualitatively, what is your view on what did you find it different in working as a team of 5 people in IIT as compared to the conventional learning that you have in your own colleges?
So it was an absolutely new experience for all of us, and I think we had a lot of learning because most of the technologies that we used, we were not familiar with before. So everything was learned from scratch, and I think what we learned to do in these 2 months will definitely help us in future.
Okay. So I have a slightly different question, is not related to this internship. What do you think you people can do after going back to your own institutions and try to instill this concept of doing group work on a topic which is not related necessarily to your syllabus, but which you collectively believe is useful? Can this experiment be replicated? Can we have almost a continuous internship within the institution itself by some people forming teams and working over a period of 4 months, 6 months, etc., part-time to achieve something different? Or this thought may not have occurred to you, but I'm just making a suggestion. Is it possible to go and spread the word? It's not necessary that you will succeed. Your colleagues, your teachers might just laugh you out. But who knows, if you pester them, they might believe that this is useful. Do you think it is possible?
I think it's definitely possible, because there will always be interested students who want to do something beyond their academia.
Okay.
So I think they'll definitely be interested.
So here is something I'll leave as a food of thought for all of you. I hope all of you are aware of the national hackathon that was conducted last year. Some of you at least would have heard of it, where 22 government departments posed problems, and almost 40,000 students from various engineering colleges participated in teams. 10,000 students were shortlisted, and those people did a 36-hour hackathon. But essentially, the teams were working on a problem for several months. Now this year, we are planning to conduct a hackathon in a much bigger way, expecting at least 1 lakh engineering college students from various colleges to participate. And there will be perhaps a larger number of prizes and recognition and different dimensions. The only squiggle is that unlike you people who represent a very cohesive group, IT, computer science, electronics, etc., the national hackathon requires you to have multidisciplinary people. I mean, there are some stipulations, like each team must have a minimum of so many girls. Okay. Very funny, but it is very gender biased. You can have a team of only girls, but you cannot have a team of only boys. As a boy, I am not very comfortable with that stipulation. However, but it also requires that students from different branches should come together and attempt to solve an interdisciplinary problem. To the best of my knowledge, this time the national hackathon is likely to be announced sometime in the month of August. And I would suggest to all of you, go back and tell your teachers and students not only about this experience, but tell them whether they would be interested in forming groups and working. And you can tell them how you learn out of the context, out of the conventional syllabus and exams and so on, which I believe is important learning. As far as your work is concerned, it's damn good, but you would be familiar with some very good animations depicting molecular models and compound models and reactions, right? Did you ever try to benchmark your work against such work that is available on the net?
We looked at a few models, as you say. Most of the 3D animations that was already present was in the form of videos. So the thing about videos is you don't have user control. You can't, it doesn't give power to the student to view it in different ways they want.
Okay.
That's the reason we use 3GIS.
No, that's not the only reason. The other reason is that if you have a video, you cannot alter it. You cannot modify it, and you cannot generate something else creative from it. You'll have to start from scratch. One fundamental aspect of open source philosophy is that whatever you create can be modified, added, etc., etc., by any number of people. That's the advantage. Incidentally, I hope the documentation has all their names and everything, because when our OER repository goes live in December, we would like to start with this and past year's work, so that that is available to people. Damn good work. Let's give them a big hand. I'm very impressed. I'm sorry I now have to leave for meetings. I only hope that all other projects show at least this level of work and this level of results. But I'm impressed with this. I have no doubt that others would have done similar kind of work.
I just wanted to share with you, this year's theme of all my projects was ideas to implementation. That's what I started. I hope that all these 25 people have realized that they are capable of taking an idea and showing the result. Okay, if they have learned that, they are set for life. Okay. So that's what is needed.
They are set to get national prizes in the hackathon, I can say that. That is what ideas to implementation is expected. Wonderful work. Thank you.